Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding what exactly is a money bill. Very important editorial written by Suhirt Parthasarthi. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2, plus this is important for public administration and political science optional students. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about the Aadhaar bill that was introduced by the government as a money bill. Now this action of the government of introducing it as a money bill has been challenged in the Supreme Court. Now the Supreme Court will be deciding whether this bill that was decided by the speaker to be introduced as a money bill, whether this action of speaker was right or wrong. Now in order to understand this editorial, first of all we will be understanding the difference between money bill and ordinary bill, and secondly we will be understanding the discretion of the office of speaker. Discretion of the office of speaker. And then we will be understanding at the last the issue of privacy. And lastly, we will be understanding what Suhirt Parthasarthi wants. Now, first of all, it is important to understand the difference between money bill and ordinary bill. Now, before we understand money bill and ordinary bill, we must also understand the difference between Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Now, as far as Lok Sabha is concerned, it is a house which has been conferred more powers with respect to Rajya Sabha. Now, why this aspect has been kept? Why it is like this, the way it is? Why Lok Sabha has got more power? Now, Lok Sabha has got more power because people directly confers powers to the member of parliament who represent themselves in Lok Sabha. It is from the Lok Sabha mostly that the government is formed. Now, for the formation of the government, it is the Lok Sabha elections which take place. Now, as far as Rajya Sabha is concerned, Rajya Sabha is primarily meant to protect the rights of the states. Rajya Sabha, the Sabha of the states. Now, when it comes to the financial matters, more power, more right, more authority has been conferred to Lok Sabha. Now the Rajya Sabha, it has got less power. Now as far as money bill is concerned, now this bill is required to be passed only by the Lok Sabha. Rajya Sabha cannot dissuade the passing of such bill. Rajya Sabha cannot stop the passing of such a bill. Rajya Sabha has less power with respect to money bill. It can only discuss. It cannot vote upon such bill. It cannot reject the passing of such a bill. But when it comes to ordinary bill, Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha, they both have got equal powers. Now this is very important. The both the houses, they have got equal powers. Now when it comes to Aadhaar bill, in its modified form, it was introduced by the Narendra Modi government as a money bill. It was introduced by them as a money bill. Now, why it was introduced as a money bill? It was introduced as a money bill because the Narendra Modi government lacked the requisite majority in the Rajya Sabha. So, in order to make it easy for them to pass this bill from the parliament, they introduced it in the form of money bill. Now, important thing to be understood here is about how this bill is categorized as a money bill or as an ordinary bill. Now, when it comes to deciding a bill, whether a bill is a money bill or an ordinary bill, discretion has been conferred by the Constitution of India. Now, it is the Constitution of India which has conferred the discretion on the office of Speaker. On the office of Speaker. It is the Speaker that has to decide about whether a bill is a money bill or a bill is an ordinary bill. Now, in order to decide it, it is the Speaker which tests the provision of the bill as per Article 110 of the Constitution. Now, what is this article? Article 110 of the Constitution delineates that there are seven conditions which, if a bill satisfies, in that case, that particular bill will be categorized as a money bill. Now, what are these provisions? There are provisions like if the matter relates to an issue of taxation, in that case, the bill will be categorized as money bill. Now, the second condition is like if the government withdraws money from the Consolidated Fund of India, in that case, a bill can be categorized as a money bill. So, Article 110, in essence, if any matter relates to Consolidated Fund of India, if any matter relates to financial issue, that bill will be categorized as money bill. There are seven conditions which this Article 110 delineates. But it is the Speaker which will be deciding at the end that whether a bill is a money bill or an ordinary bill. Now, in case of Aadhaar bill, Speaker has misused this power. And now this is being challenged in the Supreme Court. It is the Supreme Court that will be deciding whether this action of Speaker is right or this action of Speaker is wrong. Now, this discretion of Speaker was already tested by the court in one of the cases. That case is known as Sayyid Siddiqui versus State of Uttar Pradesh. Sayyid Siddiqui versus State of Uttar Pradesh. In this case, court has come to the conclusion that the judiciary will not be using its power to test the action of the Speaker. Now, what it means? It means that the judiciary will be not interfering in the discretion that has been conferred to the office of the Speaker in deciding whether the bill is a money bill or the bill is an ordinary bill. So, it is the power that has been given to the Speaker, and this power must remain intact. Now, as far as the Swirth Parthasarathi is concerned, according to Swirth Parthasarathi, this is a flagrant misuse. This is an utter misuse of the power of the office of Speaker. This is also not in consonance with the spirit of the democracy. Because a bill like an Aadhaar bill, it deals very less with the financial matters, but it deals with the issue like right to privacy. Now, how this bill deals with the issue of right to privacy? Under Aadhaar bill, no protection has been conferred whereby the data and the information of the people will be protected from any misuse. Rather, what we are witnessing is the government has already begun to share the information of the entire Aadhaar thing with the private players. Now, if you want to buy a Jio connection, in that case, you just need to tell your Aadhaar number. Now, the private companies by entering your Aadhaar bill, they will be fetching all your personal information, whatever is mentioned under your Aadhaar card. So this is actually nothing but a flagrant misuse of the private information. So according to Swarth Parthasarthi, Aadhaar like bill, they deal with substantive issues like right to privacy. They don't deal with this financial matter what is mentioned in under Article 110. So basically such a misuse of the power by the speaker is actually wrong. It is actually like thwarting democracy. It is like endangering democracy. And then it is like withering democracy. It is like killing democracy. It is like hurting democracy. So Supreme Court should constitute a larger bench whereby it should revisit its earlier verdict in Sayyid Siddiqui versus State of Uttar Pradesh case so that the rights of the people can be protected, so that the misuse of the speaker can be curtailed, because this is very important in order to protect democracy. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is BrainyIAS. You can contact me at 84594-0000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes or joining the offline batch. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.